Hello friends and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to show you like how you can use the Voto3 library, and using this Voto3 library how you can communicate to AWS services, respective services. So especially here in this session I'll show you like how you can interact with S3 services, like how you can list the buckets and how you can create the buckets in your AWS account. Okay, so we need to first import Voto3. If it is not installed, just make sure like you guys install it using pip install Voto3. Okay, and once we imported the library, then we need to initiate a client. So Voto3.client, and then we need to mention the respective service name for that, which we need to make connection. Okay, so make sure guys you mention your region name so that the bucket will get created in this region. Like when we interact with the S3 service, then it will list all the buckets. We need to mention here AWS access key ID and AWS secret access key. Okay, I have stored my access key and secret key in these two variables, and I'm using those straight away. Yeah, now let's execute this one. Okay, and now I'm able to successfully connect it to the S3 service. Okay, now let's have a look like what all buckets I have in my account. Okay, so I stored this in my response variable. We have a list buckets function which we can call upon S3. S3 is our variable here which we have stored here, and which uses a list of buckets. So let's have a look on like how we get the response. So basically we get the response in the JSON format, key and value pair. Okay, so there are basically a lot of keys here: response, metadata, then buckets. Inside buckets you can see here we have name, lot of names. So that means I have a lot of buckets in my account. Okay, so now we will iterate over these buckets, and then we'll print out the names. Like then it will give us the all list of buckets available in my account. So okay, so these are the buckets which are available. Okay, now let's create a bucket. So to create a bucket, we can use S3 dot create bucket function, and we need to specify the name of the bucket. Then we need to specify the create bucket configuration variable, where basically it's just like where you want to create your bucket. So I want to create my bucket in Asia Pacific South one region, that is Mumbai region. Okay, so this is how you need to pass the dictionary to specify the region, and let's execute it. Looks like we got the error. Okay, it is showing like you previously request to create a name bucket succeeded and you already own it. So it looks like we already have this bucket name, so that's why it is not able to create the bucket. Okay, and yeah, definitely this is expected error. Like whenever you specify the bucket name, it should be a unique bucket name. If you are specifying the bucket name which is already used by some other accounts, then definitely you will get the same error. Okay, so I'll mention here well, so that we'll be able to create this bucket. Yeah, we have successfully created the bucket. Now let's see how we got the response. Yeah, this is the HTTPS code 200. That means the bucket is created successfully. Okay, now again list the buckets. Okay, print out the response variable. This is how we got the response code. That means we have successfully created the bucket. Now again we can iterate over the buckets and print the names of respective buckets. And here you can see, as I said, this bucket is available, already created, so that's the reason I was getting that error. But yeah, we are able to create the next bucket, that is my personal testing bucket 12. Okay, and this is all about S3, like how we can create a connection, how can we can list the buckets, and how we can create the buckets. Thank you guys, thank you for watching this video, and please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.